An important part of operating a condensing turbine installation is the maintenance of correct vacuum in the condenser. Commonly, the condenser is located below the exhaust end of the turbine, but there are other configurations. In the scheme shown here, the condenser is fitted directly at the tail end of the turbine on the same level. Another arrangement, known as a pannier condenser, consists of two vessels located at the same level, one on either side of the exhaust. As we already pointed out in an earlier module, a vacuum is formed when steam exhausting from the turbine is cooled and condensed back into water. The dramatic change in volume from steam to water leaves a large empty space, and as the condenser is a closed vessel, the result is a vacuum. The actual pressure in the steam space of the condenser, and correspondingly at the turbine exhaust, will be about 1 to 2 psia, depending on actual local conditions. The steam space in the condenser is filled with low-pressure steam exhausted from the turbine, which quickly turns to water droplets as it comes into contact with the outside surface of the cooling tubes. Most condensers contain several thousand tubes about 1 inch in diameter, usually made of non-corrosive metals such as a cupro nickel, brass, and even stainless steel. Cooling water passes through the inside of these tubes while steam condenses on the outside of the tubes. This so-called condensate then falls to the bottom of the condenser, where it is collected in a vessel known as the hot well. From here, the condensate is removed by the condensate pump and circulated back to the system. In order to condense steam into water, all of the latent heat must be removed. That is about 970 BTU per pound. In order to achieve this, a very large quantity of cooling water is required. For example, a 60 megawatt unit may require as much as 35,800 GPM of cooling water to pass through the condenser. Such a large quantity of water cannot be supplied by a water treatment system. Therefore, the condenser cooling water, or circulating water as it is known, is normally taken from a nearby river or lake or even the sea. In some cases, a closed circuit system is installed using a cooling tower. We'll be talking more about the actual circulating water system and its components later in this program. For now, we're concerned with the condenser and other vacuum equipment. In the arrangement shown here, the circulating water enters at one end of the condenser, filling the inlet water box, then passes through the tubes into the outlet water box. From here, the water circulates back to the system. This particular arrangement is known as a single-pass system. In many installations, a double-pass condenser is used. Here, the water enters at the bottom, passes through the lower tubes, arrives at the far water box, and then is circulated back through the upper set of tubes, exiting from the upper water box. Over a period of time, the circulating water may leave some deposits inside the tubes. The consequence of this is a reduction in heat transfer and a rise in the back pressure inside the condenser. This results in a loss of efficiency and lower output from the turbine. The circulating water may also deposit algae, mussels, and other marine life on the front of the tube plate, reducing the flow of water through the tubes. Again, the result is a loss in cooling and a consequent rise in back pressure. Generally, the condenser needs to be cleaned manually from time to time, and in most cases, this entails shutting down the turbine. There are, however, some machines which are designed to allow one half of the condenser to be cleaned, while the other half remains in service, and the unit continues operating at reduced load. In an attempt to maintain a clean condenser, chemical injection is carried out at some installations. Adding a biocide to the circulating water can reduce or eliminate the growth of algae. Sulfuric acid may also be added in some plants where a closed cycle cooling tower system is used. The objective is to lower the pH slightly to about 6.5 in an attempt to prevent scale forming inside the tubes. Another chemical used on closed cycle systems acts as a dispersant with the aim of keeping solids in suspension and preventing deposits from forming on the inside tube surface. Many condensers are fitted with a siphon connection.